Today I'll be moving these beautiful Imperial Tropicals angelfish from this 10-gallon quarantine prison tank to this 180-gallon Angelfagus paradise. But I did encounter a few problems along the way, and I hate fish problems, but I love these angelfish. Okay, so we already know I have to get these angelfish from here to here. And fortunately for everyone involved, the second here is just right down the hall from my bedroom to the living room. And these will be my weapons of choice. A Lowe's blue bucket that has never been used for anything but fish, and my somewhat trusty siphon that has been ingeniously modded with electrical tape to keep it from kinking. So what do you say we get this thing rolling? This is going to be very stressful for these four very lucky black veil-tailed angelfish with those beautiful red eyes. So I'll be trying to mitigate that stress as much as I can, try not to make any sudden movements, and I'll be reducing the water level just enough so that they can still remain vertical while allowing me to catch them pretty easily. Now, the morsel of information that I retained from my unboxing of these guys, link to that video is in the video description, is that angelfish fins can get stuck in nets. That makes it very difficult to get them out of the net, and it can also harm the angelfish. And I don't want them to be nervous wrecks by the time I'm done with them.
You seem a little on edge. Not at all.
So I'll be using my hand to catch them. And I know this can damage the slime coating, but anything that touches them can damage the slime coating. I only touch them with wet hands, which helps tremendously. I just feel like this is the way to go with these angels. I've saved just enough water in this bucket to again allow them to be vertical, but still helping me to snatch them out. Now this must be pretty troubling for these fish to see.
Captain, that thing's a giant hand.
Trying to move smoothly and relatively slowly. Even so, they still look super stressed out, and they're kind of hard to catch even though my plan was brilliant. Well, sort of brilliant, except for one thing. And here's my first mistake. Notice them turning sideways to escape. I hadn't anticipated them sliding along the bottom of the tank, and I really didn't think about the particles of sand that came over from the plants I stole from the 180. Sliding along those pebbles wound up damaging some of their scales. Once I catch them, I'll gently cup them in my hand and carefully plop them into the bucket. I would show you all of them, but I think you get the idea. And speaking of getting the idea, I would love it if you had the idea to like and subscribe if you've made it this far into my video. All right, time to get these babies into their new home. I'm still using my hand only, but maybe this isn't the best way to catch your angelfish. I think it would have been fine if I'd had just a bit more water in the quarantine prison tank and no sand on the bottom. I am by no means an angelfish expert, so please, please, please drop a comment to let me know what's worked for you or what hasn't worked for you. There's number one in his new digs. I'll show you one more and then I'll get to my second issue with these guys. Into the great hand you go, little guy. By the way, you would normally float these guys in their new aquarium for 10 to 15 minutes to acclimate them, but my water temperature is the same in both tanks, and they didn't have to travel very far, so they're going right in. The current occupants of the 180 don't seem too concerned about the new kids that just appeared out of nowhere. They're more concerned about what I'm doing, and the Black Angels are all huddled together, probably devising a game plan for how to handle this new situation. As with any time I add fish to an existing tank, I drop in some food so my old residents will be fat, lazy, and therefore maybe distracted and not too aggressive to their roommates. This is important because by their name alone, angelfish sound like they should be the sweetest fish on earth, but in reality, they're still cichlids, so they can actually act like devils. Speaking of devils, here comes the biggest butthead in the entire tank, Wilbur. He's named Wilbur after the pig in Charlotte's Web because he's a pig. At least he eats like one. He's also the tank boss and gets a little grouchy at times. Even so, he doesn't even really seem to notice the black veils. In fact, no one does. It's like they've been here forever. Or maybe like they're not even here at all. I'm keeping the light off for a while to help keep the stress down a bit and maybe keep them unnoticed for a while. So here we are later that night with the light on for a bit, so I can show you what they look like. And also show you my second mistake. Actually, it's not really a mistake, but more my second problem. I was worried about this before I bought them, but I did it anyway. Black angels with a black background. Maybe a little hard to see them. Kind of like they're phantoms in the night. Where the heck are they? Very hard to see sometimes. I can see them when they're in front of something that isn't black, but there's a lot of black. So here's the thing. I have this driftwood in the center of the tank. I soaked it in super hot water in a giant tub for weeks, until the water looked clear to me after several hours of soaking in it. So I thought all the tannins were gone. However, after adding it to the tank, I noticed the water getting a green haze after a single day. It isn't an algae bloom. The light is only on for about 6 hours a day, and there's hardly any algae on the glass. I also have very low nitrates. So I bought some purigen to clear it up, but then I had an idea. A genius idea. I'd been wanting some decor from a company called Aqua Decor for some time, but they cost a fortune. So I never did. But now, I've decided I'll be forking out the dough and get what I've been wanting all along. Stay tuned for that video when I remove the fake plants and the driftwood to replace them with something I'm really excited about. And it should help these black angels show up better with this black background. Have any of you ever used Aqua Decor? Let me know in the comments what you think about your experiences with them. I've heard nothing but good things. I also might be using them for my African cichlid tank decor. That tank has had some miserable occurrences this past week. I'll be posting a video about that soon as well. Looks like the new guys are doing just fine, right? I mean, hanging out with the old guys and no one seems to really mind at all. Maybe they are angels and not devils after all. You know, I think these black angelfish are actually my favorite. Well, next to Wilbur, I mean. Wilbur's gorgeous. He looks like he has jewels on his fins. But I love the shape of the fins on the new guys. Imperial Tropicals has really impressed me. They always do. Have you used them? I never hear anything bad about them either. If you missed this video where I unbox these guys, be sure to check it out. It's up here in the right corner. Just click on it. You know you want to.